Yo, what up? Welcome to another episode of 17 Straight Gear Show. I am your host, Jay Brown.
You got a heaven applause.
17.
That's cute.
This is a different look out here in these streets this evening. Erica and Joy, baby Joy, is on their way. They just walked in. And we are joined by our special guest with her.
Real special guest.
Well, real special guest.
And you better turn up when you say
and
my name.
All of her lips.
Hey, girl, you better bring that belly. Come on. Where you sitting at over here?
You on that side over there.
Come on, boo.
Don't worry about it. All right.
Okay, what you say?
We out here in these streets with the Kiana Dancy and all that lipstick in
these
streets.
Where's my applause, sir?
What up?
Hello?
Hold on, wait. Oh, yeah. You can go ahead and hit it one time.
Right.
Hit it one time.
Hey, girl.
How are you?
How you doing? You're a little late, but I'll accept it.
No,
not you, but him, but you too.
I was late on the applause.
Hey, girl. Yes, I love them edges. Come on, edges. Pull through. Okay.
Hey,
hey, so, Rhonda.
Yeah, he going to go ahead and take care of that.
Mm-hmm.
That's what I'm talking about. Let me tell you real quick.
What?
You're going to look at the little one, not the screen. I know it's tempting.
Look at the little one. I wasn't sure where to look, but thank you for the
I know it's tempting.
The late heads up.
Well, I just saw your eyes. It's all good, though. Don't worry about it. Hey, I am glad you all are tuning in this evening. This is the Inactive Show, so you know how we gets down. We like, share, comment. Go ahead and call in. The phone number is 470-251-4343.
Say the number again.
It is 470-251-4343. It's the number to dial. If you want to talk to the Kiana Dancy, if you want to be part of the Dancy Darlings, you can go ahead and call in and,
yes,
and put in your resume.
You better put in some research. Okay, that's cute.
Now, as a grown man, I am...
you could be a darling. Someone has called you darling in your life before.
Where's my bell? Has anybody seen my bell? But yeah, look, go ahead and like, share, and comment. If you haven't shared this feed already, I'm pretty sure you got some five-year-olds in your family that got receding hairlines. But let's go ahead and get that thing done real quick for your boy. What's up? Hey, so, listen. Yeah, that's my man.
First of all, what we not finna do is be ringing a bell on me. What does the bell mean?
The bell won't mean a whole bunch of things. It just depends on what goes on.
Amen. Oh, so go ahead and click. Bam, you can be a dancy darling. Okay, go ahead.
I don't know. I'm not a barb, not in the beehive, and I'm not part of the Navy, so I'm still...
You're not going to be part of the Navy? Okay. No. Come on, Word Association.
Not quite.
What we got? Quite.
And so, on tonight's show, we're going to do, since last week, as we do always, we're going to learn a whole lot about Miss V. Kiana Dancy.
Oh, gosh.
And then we're going to recap some of our favorite topics and get Kay's take on that. On that goodness, because mm-hmm. this is gonna be interesting. I have seen this woman perform before. She's the comedian extraordinaire, Kiana Dancy.
Okay,
and she was real funny. So
because you came down to the Atlanta Comedy Theater and you saw me there,
mm-hmm.
your wife and yourself, right?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so what day was that?
You was with you did a set. You wasn't hosting that day. It was actually you.
Oh.
Yeah, this is a wild
one. Well, let me make sure I clarify something. Even if I'm hosting, I still perform. So just because the host is one of the most important parts of the show. Come on. Is that an amen? Yes. The host is one of the most important parts of the show, because if you don't have a good host, you don't have a show. Like, even if everybody on the show. Absolutely. Even if everybody is funny on the show, if the host is...
It's not engaging and not getting the audience horrible. Warmed up.
Or the opposite. If the rest of the show is terrible, the host can bring it up. Right. Okay. So that's what I'm saying. You need a 5-5-5-5 host.
So y'all can see who we're talking to. That is... The Kiana.
What Dancy up, y'all?
With the Erica Tiffany.
Hey,
in the streets. All right. And so, look, since last week,
mm-hmm.
anything exciting happened to y'all since last week?
Happened to me or us?
Both of y'all. We moving on down the line.
What? No, listen.
We gonna start with
you. Yeah, start with you, girl, because I got to see what you're going to say. Where are we going? Did you get pregnant last week and you blew up this
week?
I did.
And I'm still pregnant.
Clearly.
I'm not happy about it.
Well, how long you got?
I got 5 more days.
5 more days?
Yes.
Oh, you don't even look that big.
Yes, she's not coming, and We're just counting down right now.
Well, let me keep it 100. I didn't get pregnant last week, but I didn't get pregnant last week, but I will tell you, you know, what was I doing last week? Last week was a very long week for me. Last week was Valentine's, right. So I worked all week. I literally worked Wednesday through Sunday. I turned up. I made some money. You know what I mean? I had a band at my club. Yeah.
Okay. What?
Look, I have a band called the Improv Band. They were super dope. I have CJ, the drummer, and them other two, I don't know. But listen, I guess they switch out. But the drummer is the staple. Drummer, okay. You know what I mean? So CJ was there, and he tore it down. And I brought my sweetie out there, a little steak and lobster dinner, honey. We did it big. And then I literally worked Monday through, what was it? Wednesday through Sunday, all day and all night. That's what I did. So I tired. I rested up.
That's what I'm talking about.
What you talking about?
That's exactly what I'm talking about. Go ahead and get that bread and enjoy those of it. Valentine's Day was actually the week before.
Well, whatever. I don't know what I did. Why are you giving that wrong information?
I'm just saying it was in that time frame.
You got pregnant, mine.
Baby brain.
Baby brain. It's all good. So since last week, you know, I went to a funeral in Chicago this weekend. Mm. And
what was our last weekend?
Yeah, it was
in the shot at the same time?
At the same time.
So what was wrong with the people at the what I learned about Chicago, them people are interested, honey. When I say they dress down, baby, this lady had you know the tassel that you put on your curtain?
Mm-hmm.
The ones that you don't really take them off. They're huge.
Girl,
baby, she had that thing around her neck like a necklace. She came down to kill him. And I wasn't mad about it, but I was very interested. Like, what would make you look at it and say, you know what?
Oh, this is cute.
That's going to be a necklace, and I'm going to kill these hoes with that thing.
She must have been from the South Side.
She was had to be. And she was really? She was very jazzy.
They already in the chat room trying to shoot their shot, but they understand. They just heard that.
Shoot what shot?
Yeah, that buddy. They said, don't worry about it. Three! That you had just mentioned that. Sweetie was with you, so.
Oh, so the people think I'm saying, oh, no, I'm not available.
No shot shooting today.
Although, I think he's trying to dump me. I'm like, who's getting dumped after Valentine's Day, boy? You gonna pull up? You better hold on. Let me, you know, wait a minute now, okay? That would not be smart. Right. Mm-mm. That's all right.
Ain't no shot shooting today, so.
Right, I got on my bulletproof vest. Ain't nothing you can do around here, sir.
If you go to her website, disregard that part of, like three paragraphs down, disregard that.
What'd it say? Why need to update the website? It says I'm single.
Amen.
Girl, the people need to get, I told y'all I fired my assistant.
Okay, yeah.
So there's a lot of things that need to be updated.
Yeah, we need to go ahead
and
update.
She's hiring too.
Okay.
All
right, cool. But yeah, back to this funeral. So the funeral was going as planned.
Mm-hmm.
You had your opening remarks, had your scripture, had your good stuff in there. And then they got to the remarks. And the remarks, you already know.
Just when people get to come up and say their 2 cents.
Well, first of all, can you tell us who died?
That was my uncle.
Your uncle died.
My Uncle Tony, yeah.
So was he a Rolling Stone? Was he a husband? What kind of man was he?
My Uncle Tony was a husband.
He was a husband with multiple families?
No.
Oh, okay. Well, we were trying to find out what kind of man he was, right? Okay.
The whole team.
Okay, so to give background, Uncle Tony lived the alternative lifestyle. He had a husband.
Oh.
And
come on now. How old was Uncle Tony?
Uncle Tony was about 60.
Listen, can I please say I met so many gay men in the shy this past week. You cannot tell me that only gay men live in Atlanta. That is not true. Girl, when I tell
San
you
Francisco.
Boom, 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 it was gay men everywhere. Not where. Well.
Well.
Where'd you go?
I was in Chicago.
No. It just wasn't just out in the open now.
No, they not. No, they wasn't out in the open.
It was a place.
But they were very gay.
It was a place. You was on the north side.
No, I was in Oakland.
Okay.
Are you from Chicago?
Yeah.
Oh, well, I was up that way, child. All
right. And so, look. They got to the remarks.
Ooh.
Mark 1, cool. Remark 2, cool.
This is family or friends?
Family.
Okay.
Two families. Another family. Then a friend got up, and everybody, somebody here who worked, he worked at the post office for 35 years.
Come on,
so
post office.
He knew them folks.
Right.
He delivered a whole bunch of mail packages to the wrong place. But it doesn't. That part does not matter. In this moment, his brother got up.
Oh.
His brother, we was in the church, and he said, I normally don't get up in these moments, but Tony put something on my heart, and I just want to let you guys know that if I know a whole bunch of y'all had a problem with his lifestyle. And if you do have, if you did have a problem with it, he just wanted me to say, fuck him.
Oh, at the church?
Now, is this the first time the lifestyle's been brought up in the whole program?
Everybody knew.
But it had to be. It was on the obituary. My husband. Yeah, Tony Lee's a husband.
This is 27 years.
Right. You know, 27 years. If, like at 60, then it's, you know, it's not talked about as much as it is if he was 30.
Girl, oh. 27 years of was, them was, loving on each other, child. That's his husband.
This was not a secret.
Okay.
Not a secret.
Well, what kind of gay man was he? Was he a flaming flamboyant, or was he very conservative?
He was flashy. He was flashy.
Chi-town flashy, but not.
Yeah, but he wasn't. Nah, he wasn't Lennox Mall.
Ooh, shots. What can we?
Yeah, you got it. Whenever you need. Whenever you need it.
Come on now.
But yeah, when he dropped that,
the F word in the church.
Oh.
So was there a collective?
Yeah, you know, like when the plane go down 100 feet by accident. Everybody's like,
oh. But yeah. I'm sure people knew.
No.
Oh, people didn't know?
They didn't know that he was going to do
that. Yeah, yeah, sure. Sorry.
You still in the church.
They didn't know he was going to do that.
Girl,
he set that whole
microphone on fire. People don't regard the church like they used to.
Oh, you still in the church.
Needless to say that I was not going to get up behind that one. The remarks were over at this
point. It was over. Yeah, you don't go behind that.
And the bishop decided that it was his time to go. He was going to
clean
amen.
It up.
He was going to amen.
No.
That if you F him up out of there.
He was going to clean it up.
Yeah, so he was like, he gets up there and he got his tablet. He was like, amen, amen, everybody, amen. Let me go ahead and, Lord Jesus.
He was
amen.
Sweating.
Amen. Let's go ahead and we're going to get this thing going and get it moving on, amen. And we're going to get this thing started. Hold on, amen.
He was struggling.
For technology.
He was struggling.
Amen, amen.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, I'm going to get up and say what I got to say, amen, instead. Sit down, amen. Get up, amen, say what I got to say, amen, and sit down, amen, and when I get done, I'm going to go over to Harold's Chicken and get me a six-piece wing, amen.
No, he didn't.
Get a Coke, amen. And as soon as this...
Was he trying to get his little situation working?
Yeah.
Oh, okay. But you know, it's funny that you say Harold's Chicken, because when I was there, I realized Harold's Chicken delivered on Uber Eats. And baby, when I tell you I couldn't get my debit card to work on that Uber Eats app, and I was so mad because my card expires. I'm in the hotel mad because I'm like, this is where the people say that you need to get the good chicken because it's different in Chicago, right?
Yeah, it ain't the same.
It's not the same. I wanted some chicken, girl.
Okay.
Girl, I was hot.
Dang, you should have said some more amen.
Amen.
A lot going on in Chicago over the last.
Well, I didn't know he was there. I went for to celebrate a friend of mine parents. They had their 60th anniversary, and the father turned 85. So wow. I actually did. I didn't host it, but I performed at the anniversary party. And when I tell you, it was 300 people there.
Wow.
I thought it was just going to be a small little engagement, but it's three. It was 300 people came out, and it was like that's a comedy club.
Absolutely.
Mm-hmm. It was cute. Oh, and I looked cute. Go ahead. I ring the bell for myself.
Listen, oh yeah. And if you ever take a lift.
A lift where?
If you ever take a lift in Atlanta.
Okay.
Anywhere. And Old Joe pops up, decline.
Who was Old Joe?
That was his lift driver.
Old Joe is the worst lift driver in the world. on the planet.
What'd he do?
I gave that boy no tip and one star. That boy is horrible. And the only reason why he got a star is because I made it safely, but I had to run to get to my plane.
You know, I don't really do Lyft or Uber.
He's like, going the wrong way.
I'll be honest with you, my sweetie, he typically drives me where I need to go because I hate to drive and I hate to pump gas. Hello? So,
listen. You got your own.
Yeah, I'd be like, baby, I got to go somewhere. And he'd be like, well, what time we got to go? You know what I mean? So, yeah, I don't have to do that.
Voice really sound like that when he asks what time.
No, he'd be happy to take me.
No, it's the deep.
That's first of all. Let me explain something. Let me explain something. That's also security. No, that's a killer over there. Don't play. You know.
Okay, and so this boy drove.
Oh, we still talking about the lift.
This boy couldn't see.
Okay.
He couldn't see, and he only drove about 20 miles an hour.
But you know what? The man's trying to make his living, so don't do that to him. Give him the opportunity to earn his coin.
Does he get more money for going slow?
No, he doesn't get a ticket if he go fast. That's what, he doesn't get a ticket if he go fast.
Now, this boy was horrible.
Okay.
All right, so.
Shout out to Keith Davis that's watching me on my Facebook Live, Shanita Wilkins. Hey, y'all.
What up, Keith? What up, Shanita? How you living in these streets? All right, and so let's move on over to this Kiana Dancy.
Okay.
Interview.
Okay.
We're just going to get a chance to know you a little bit more. You're originally from Cleveland.
Yes.
And she was one of the 13 people that did not burn a LeBron James jersey.
Hilarious.
Shout out to Cleveland.
Shout out. Listen, let me be honest with you. I love me some Cleveland. That is hometown. It will always be hometown for me. But I only go home, to be honest with you, when people get married or buried. You know what I mean? Like, Atlanta is home for me. I've been here since I was 9 years old. My mom is here. And I always say home is wherever your mama is, you know, or where you got a panty drawer. And depending on where you got a panty drawer, girl, I got two or three, but I am definitely, this is home. So I love Cleveland, but it's too cold for me. My immediate family is there. All of my mother's sisters are there. My grandmother is buried there. My grandfather is buried there. Rest in peace. My father also. But I just, Cleveland will always be home, but Atlanta, you know what I'm saying? I always say that I'm a Georgia girl with a Texas heart because I lived in Texas too.
Okay.
Come on now.
San Antonio?
All right. Houston. H-Time.
Oh! See somebody? Never mind.
Okay.
Anyway, yeah. Shout out to Houston and all those good, fine folks down there. All right. There is probably going to be 500 people at my wedding if I ever get married.
What are you talking about?
That's probably not going to happen. This is a chat room.
Oh. All
right. And so my new hometown, I got a lot of homes. All right. Anyway. So, let me see. So, I told you guys I first saw Kiana do comedy at Atlanta Comedy Theater. How long have you been in the comedy game?
So, it's been about 8 years. I started doing stand-up because, well, it's probably a little longer than that, but I started doing stand-up because I was going through a breakup. Mm. And so I would tell my girlfriends about what happened. Girl, this, and da-da-da.
You're animated.
Girl, right. So my friends was like, girl, you got to tell that on stage. And I was like, really? I'm not going to put my business out here in these streets. So it was a thing that I kind of, as I was going through a breakup, I used comedy to heal myself whole. You know what I mean? So it was a tough time in my life. I was with my ex from 19 to 29. As I walked away from him based on various reasons, I was just like, you know what? I'm going to use this, girl.
Were you already used to being on stage?
Well, Toastmasters, okay, and things of that nature.
Comfortable.
I've always been in the entertainment industry. I was a child actor. Girl, listen. Trivia. I used to model for JCPenney's. I was a catalog girl. So I've always been in front of people. I traveled with the African dance troupe. My mom actually used to dance for Soul Train. Get that.
Word.
So we've always I'm the one they call radio in my family. They used to say, shut radio up. She keep talking. but you know, at the end of the day, I started doing stand up and I did it on a dare to do open mic. And they loved me and I was funny. And here I am.
Quick question about your mom's. Was she friends with the Asian lady that could dance real good?
I don't know, but I will tell you this. There was a time, I'm sure my mother knew her. There was a time that Soul Train traveled from the Midwestern cities. And we're too young for that, but Soul Train would travel from like Chicago, Cleveland, Pittsburgh, Philly, St. Louis. It would travel to all the Midwestern cities. And my mother traveled to a couple of those, I think three or four of those cities with this gay guy named James, honey. Everybody had a gay dance partner named James. Ow, ow.
The gay dude named James. That was Uncle Tony friend.
Oh, okay. Well, it might have been.
Well, rest his soul. So,
hey, Tiff.
So, how long was that first set?
5 minutes. When you do open mic, it's usually 5 minutes. Now, if you're not doing it well, it's like, you know what I'm saying? It's like, no, if you're not doing it well, girl, it's like 20 minutes, 2 hours, 2 days. You're up there burning at the stake. But it was 5 minutes. I mean, if you're doing it, if you kill, like really, really kill, and it's funny because comedians use the word, oh, he killed, meaning good, or he got killed, meaning bad. So you got to pay attention to that. But I killed, and they loved me, and they invited me back, and that was the last stop in Houston.
Wow.
Okay. And it was amazing because I knew that I was funny, but I didn't know if I was funny enough to make money. And I ended up winning a contest, and it was crazy how I won that contest. I won that contest and against a lot of the vets in the city.
Wow.
And that was to open up for Cat Williams.
What?
Yes, open for Cat Williams and $1,000. Now, baby, I had 7 minutes, and he was paying me for 10. I was going to find me 3 more minutes of comedy. You hear me?
I know, that's right.
Oh, absolutely.
Murked it.
Absolutely. So one thing one of the questions that I have for you was, you know, you have people that are funny and then you have people that are funny enough to make money? What separates those people?
Courage. The reason some people get out on stage is because they have the heart to. Just like with anything. Sure. There's a lot of people who are successful or are good at what they do. Let's say, drop the word successful, just say good at what they do. Mm-hmm. We know some people who are, I'm talking about family reunion, funny, you hear me? But they would never go on stage.
Right.
There's a comfort zone that people have based on who they are and within their little social circle. But put them in front of a mic, a stage, and a light, they can't do it.
And strangers.
And strangers, they can't do it. Honestly, what I've, and then you will learn that it's easier sometimes to perform in front of bigger crowds than smaller crowds. Mm-hmm. Smaller crowds tend to be a little bit more judgmental, mm-hmm. and they can see you. You feel like, ooh, go, you know, it's too much, it's right. too small. And big crowds, you know, laughter is contagious. So if you kill, if five people laugh in that big crowd, everybody gonna laugh. You know what I mean? Right. So it's just one of those things. You just have to have the heart to actually go out and do it. And have, like, one of the comedians that I really, really, really respect, her name is Jess Hilarious. She's mm-hmm. a young gun in the business, but she's one that came up real fast because literally she held nothing back. Jess went to war with everybody. She mm-hmm. went to war with rappers, comedians. She went to war with actors. And that's how her name became popular, because not only does she do something called Jess with the Mess, but she also, she don't care. So she would take her wig off and all mm-hmm. these things that I ain't gonna do, girl. You ain't gonna see me down to the in these streets with my good Cleo cornrows. You hear me?
Ponytail.
But she is one of those fearless people. So when you get into this business, you have to just be fearless and not care what anybody say or will do.
Yeah, I was that dude that did a family reunion set.
And, did you burn?
I killed, but they love me, so I couldn't.
Right.
I couldn't fail.
Hey, Shannon.
I wasn't gonna base that and be like, oh yeah, I made them laugh. I'm about to go hop on stage.
Well, that
like,
could have been that really could have been a gauge for you, because now that you knew that you can make your family laugh, which sometimes is the hardest, mm-hmm. you can go to the comedy club and do a high five. It starts with just 5 minutes, mm-hmm. and really, to be honest with you, some comedy clubs will give you 2 or 3 minutes.
Dang.
Right.
Now, I got 2 minutes. Right. I do got 2 minutes.
Right.
But yeah, no. It was a few years ago. And mm-hmm. I was like, I like this. Mm-hmm. I like this. I'm
radio. Bam. Yeah. Wait a minute. You didn't go through all them questions on this piece of paper here.
You don't use all the jokes.
Clearly.
This ain't all in order right now.
Okay, well, whatever. Go ahead.
I've been doing stuff. So when you hosting.
Uh huh.
Have you ever had to stop somebody or help somebody when they were bombing?
Yes. That happens quite often because I am kind of a strong host. I have a big personality. My cadence is very fast. I take the energy up real high. So sometimes, even as the host, it's hard to follow me. I will say... But I try to leave something. I always say I leave something there for them to eat. You know what I mean? You don't want to destroy the room to the point where nobody can come behind you. The goal as the host, a good host, is to get the crowd ready for the next person to follow, whether that's an amateur, that's a feature, or the headliner. Your goal is to get the room so hot that if they walk into it, it's ready.
Mm-hmm.
So, yeah, I didn't pick up a couple faces off the floor, though. Couple people didn't bomb. I didn't have to douse them with some water. You know what I mean? Like, you didn't bomb, boy.
You gotta resuscitate them.
Right, mouth to mouth, right.
Now, is that funny to comedians when somebody bomb?
Oh, we wear you out. We wear your ass out. If you fail. Can I say ass? I think. Anyway.
Yeah, from
right, you definitely can... We go in on them. You know, comedians, that's what we do. We, you know, we hold you accountable. Oh, that wasn't funny. You only as funny as your last set. So, like, mm-hmm. if you bombed yesterday, all right, well, you bombed yesterday. Come back tomorrow.
Right.
You know what I mean? Well, I killed 2 weeks ago. That was 2 weeks ago. But yesterday, last night, you died. You're dead. We put you in the box. We buried you. It's dirt on your face. You hear me? So, yeah.
Have you ever died?
Actually, yeah. So, first time ever in life. First time ever in life. I have never had a horrible set ever. Never been bombed, nothing until I went to the Apollo.
What?
But, you know, here's how petty my mama is. She was like, well, if you gonna get booed, you might as well get a professional boo. The Apollo.
Why
the,
not?
The Apollo, they like, it's a certain, you know, shout out to my girl, Sweet Baby Keita. She actually won Apollo. It's just, it's a very weird dynamic in New York. Sometimes they're regional, sometimes they're not, meaning they laugh at certain things that they can relate to. Sometimes it just depends. On that particular day, I ain't gonna lie, it was a rough day for me. And I mean, and my friend kept saying, "What you doing here? What you doing here? Girl, you don't need to be here. You're professional." I was like, "But they giving me money." You know what I'm saying? Yeah. So, yeah, that's how you sometimes you go for the money with all money and you don't need.
Absolutely. They say all money ain't good money.
Money, but some of it you don't need neither.
Hey, look, if y'all got any questions or comments for Ms. The Kiana Dancy, 470-251-4343. Some of these folks be getting nervous in these streets.
I like my name.
Yeah, that's what I'm talking about.
Say it again. The Kiana Dancy.
The Kiana Dancy.
Ow, ow. Hey, Tina Jones.
So, in that, how did you feel after that? Like, that, I feel like I would be, like, for me, I've had bad basketball games. Mm-hmm. And I've had shows even here in which when I got done, it was probably the worst I had ever felt. And I was just like, I don't ever want to feel that way again. Now, I'm not going to stop doing shows, but at the same time, I know what I don't want to feel ever again.
So remember, you can only be defeated by what you let defeat you. You know what I'm saying? So when I went onto that stage, I wasn't studying. At the end of the day, I didn't win the money. I was in front of people who didn't know who I was. And also, I gained new followers. So in addition to that, what I just
said.
You
found a win.
I found a win every mm-hmm. time. Also, in addition to that, I say that you're only as funny as your next set. So I had something to prove, not to them, but to myself. You know, so I went home and destroyed. Right. You know, now I have something to do. Okay. You know, I'm like, oh, New York don't like me, but let me tell you what California do. They love me. You know what I'm saying? So the thing is, you don't use that. Hello? You gonna answer the call in the middle of my hello? Okay. You don't let the people. you don't let a bad set deter you from keeping, you know, forging forward. Hello?
No, I ain't doing that.
The phone ain't ringing.
Yeah, it's up now.
Oh, that's how we gonna do?
Yeah.
Hey, James.
What up, James? Anyway. Okay, so what can you describe to people what actually goes into a set? Because this, I mean, most people just see comedians just pop up there and then they have along, whether it's a special or, you know, just a.
The best comedians always make it look like they're not rehearsed. The best comedians also look like they just off the top of their head. Even when it looks like you know, when they're going off in the audience or something, that's not what it is. Mm-hmm. It's been rehearsed, it's been written, they're stock jokes. You always keep, what I've been taught was always keep one in the chamber mm-hmm. so that when you need to use it, shots fire. You know what I mean? Because there's always going to be somebody in the audience who think they're funnier than you, always going to be somebody in audience that is drunk, always somebody in the audience is doing something they don't need to be doing.
So you pick up, you decide what kind of person you're looking for.
No, you just be ready. I mean, if you just have a bunch of them, you know what I'm saying, ready.
So like, all right, there's my drunk guy, so I got my drunk guy joke.
Right.
There's my girl who ain't paying no attention.
Yes, that, and also it might be off the dome, but because we are a professional and this is what we do, you're ready all the time. The one thing, life lessons, if you stay ready, you never have to get ready.
Right. Right. And so for the hecklers,
you don't want this.
I'm pretty sure they've taken their shots.
Yeah. I mean, what you gonna say? I got big eyes and a gap in my teeth. You ain't said nothing. I don't know. You know what I'm saying? Like, first of all, you got the. It's interesting when people say things like, "Oh, what's your big old gap? Ow, you want one?" You know what I mean? So the thing is, I don't get offended because first of all, people have to. They can only make fun of you and make you feel some kind of way about things that you are insecure about.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? Like, I don't feel no kind of way about my gap. There's nothing you can say about my gap. One, that I hadn't heard. Two, I don't feel no kind of way. Like, you, what? Do you know, with this gap, I can do a lot of things with it. I feel an apple and an orange at the same time. You know what I'm saying? So it's nothing that anybody can say to me. Bam. There's nothing that anyone can say to me that I hadn't heard. I'm a stand-up comedian. That's what people do. We joan each other all day long. But, you know, at the end of the day, big eyes, big gap, lips, ow, all that. I'm petty, but I'm pretty. You know what I mean? So what do you do?
I love it.
So you just, hecklers are always looking for some attention. Mm-hmm. And they think they want it. They really do think they want that attention until you go pow, 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 dead. And then we go back and say, hey, it's a heckler out there, front rows to the right, da 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 da. And then every comedian behind him wear their ass out.
You ever had somebody just leave? Just like,
yeah. it was a comedian named Steve Brown that got into it with somebody in a comedy club, and I don't really know what exactly happened because I didn't see the video, but apparently him and the guy got into an altercation because Steve was messing with him, I think. But eventually, that guy got up and was like, hey, I'm gonna kill you. And then they got into a fight.
The guy was swinging the microphone stand at Steve Brown. Like, he was up there and he was actually going at him like he had a...
I think I saw he had a mental illness, though.
No, right?
He was just out of jail. That's what that was.
Okay.
It wasn't no mental illness. That man was fresh out.
He had a problem. Yeah, that video was crazy. Like, yeah, I mean, you out here talk, but they always say it's always that one person that be in the audience that just be like, hey, yeah, you probably don't want to mess with that person.
Yeah, it's all, you never know. And the thing is, people have so much going on in their life right now. Sure. People are dealing with so many things. There's you can pull the trigger and not know that you're talking who you're talking to. Mm-hmm. The crazy thing about that is people come to the comedy clubs with all these chips on their shoulder, and the goal is to come to the comedy club and just be happy. Just have a good time. Come in here and laugh, relax. That term, relax, is the term that we use and my boyfriend and I often. Mm-hmm. Relax. Like, let's just chill, because at the end of the day, it's not that big of a deal.
Right.
It's only a big deal if you make it a big deal. You know what I'm saying? So we be like, man, relax. Chill out.
That's what I'm talking about.
Hey, Angela. Hey, Sharice.
Your cousin Irma is here.
Who? My cousin Irma?
Somebody's cousin
Irma. Mine.
Oh, I'm about to say I got a cousin named Irma. Girl, ain't no telling. Because let me tell you something.
All kind of new family.
Right. On. Since I've been on TV, girl. Since I've been on TV, I've had a brother DM me. And he really is probably my brother, but I ain't never met him. He was in prison. Shout out to you. But.
Well, I done found a whole dad in Cleveland.
You had a daddy, girl?
Mm-hmm. I just found out I had a dad in Cleveland.
You didn't know you had a daddy? She got a baby and a daddy in the same.
Do you know your daddy for real? Are you playing?
I just found out. Like 2 weeks ago.
You didn't know your daddy? No. Bless your heart.
No, I knew him, but it was the wrong one.
Oh.
Right. Amen.
So he got some money, girl. You better put some papers on that daddy. That's what I should have did. If I was smart. Let me tell you something now, ladies and gentlemen. Put some insurance on your people. Because when they go look back down and toes up, you want to have a coin. If I was smart, I would have put my daddy call and told him, rest in peace. But when he called me and told me he had a heart transplant or whatever they had, honey, I should have said, well, what's your social security number? Although I knew it, but it was too late by then. You can't put no
pre-existing conditions.
You can't put no insurance on the man with a good bad heart.
No, can't do it. They're gonna be like, yeah, we gotta run a couple tests.
Yeah,
he just jumped in, like hit that bell.
Right,
hit that bell.
Look, the whole family in the chat
they all
right
in
now.
There.
Go ahead.
And somebody
said, hey, Sammy.
He has no cash. That's what Yolanda.
He said he don't have no cash.
That's
girl.
What Yolanda.
Don't be talking about my daddy like that.
What you gonna do with your new daddy, girl?
Oh, we gonna meet. We gonna do it.
How you know he your dad? You took a DNA test.
So the craziest thing is, so his sister took a DNA test doing one of those heritage ancestries, and so then I had done one 6 months earlier, and it connected us. And so I was like, Mom, I told my mom, I said, how am I connected to this person, but they're not connected to you? And she was like, well, ask him a couple questions. And we get to a couple questions, got answered.
Did your mama not know who your daddy was? Girl, sweet tea. Tell me, girl.
Don't be using this in your standard.
It's too late, isn't it? Let me tell you, people. I always tell the people, no matter what is going on, if you're talking to me, you're going to become part of my
family's in Cleveland.
Girl, I know. Your daddy might have been my daddy. Your daddy. Oh, my daddy dead. But this is what I'm saying. Your information will be used. I just won't use your name. You know what I'm saying? What's your daddy name, girl? What's your last name?
Peter.
You from Cleveland for real?
I am now.
Well, wait. She your daddy named Peter?
Yeah.
Girl, okay, Peter. biblical name. Okay, Peter. Okay.
That's not his real name, but I don't want you to use it.
Well, that's all right, Peter, with the new baby down here in Atlanta. Hey. And she about to have a baby. You better send some money. We need some Pampers. Okay.
New grown baby.
New grown baby. And I will be acting like, daddy, I need, I want. Okay.
Listen, he said it was like having a baby shower. I mean, you find out you have a kid 35 years later. It's like.
Come on, 35.
And I have a sister.
But did your mama know him?
She knew him for...
She wasn't trying to tell you?
This is what happened. They're on a military base.
Girl, your mama slept with this man and she left.
They had a little, you know...
A little thing.
But then my other dad married her when she was pregnant. So I think she was like, well, look, I mean, I got this guy who's just a fling.
See, that's a good man.
This guy, yeah.
That's
yeah,
what I'm saying. I speak highly of men who are willing to take care of a woman and her seed. Now, he wasn't sure. Was he not sure?
He wasn't sure. He said he was like, I'm with it. Let's go. Let's get married. Let's do a thing. But the thing is, later on in life, when I grew up and I saw me and my sister didn't look alike, I said, why don't we look alike? Well, tell me the answers. And she acted like,
girl, your mom was like, this is not your business. Okay, let's talk about me. Let's stop talking about you. Come on now. We ain't here to talk about you, girl. Your daddy, Peter.
Hey, so when people see you out in public, are they expecting you just to be funny or they just talk to you like?
A combination of things, yes. It depends on where they see me at. If they first were introduced to me by way of Sister Circle Live, yes, they think that... Well, they really want to talk to me all about Sister Circle Live, okay? They want to know about all the co-hosts. They want to know, oh, my God, I didn't know you was this. They always say they didn't know I was this short.
How tall are you?
I'm 5'4 and a half.
Aww.
But, girl, I wear a mean shoe. You hear me?
Go ahead and take that half off.
I am not. You see these shoes? Look at this thing. This. Wait. Well, anyway, I am 5'4 and a half. I actually put on my paperwork that I'm 5'5". So I'm a tall woman and I'm 8 feet in my heart. You know what I mean?
Big heart.
Come on. So the thing is, people want to talk to me about various things, but mostly they're like, tell me a joke. And I'm like, tell you a joke? What I'm not finna do is stand down here in Kroger in aisle 7 and tell you no joke.
You're not a laughing taffy
rapper. Okay. And people think that you're always on. And what people fail to realize as a comedian, you know, we have highs and we have lows, but we pull from those, you know, that energy to become funny. And I'm not, and actually many of my comedian friends are quiet. Mm-hmm. See, I'm either on or I'm off. When I get home, my sweetie always say, but you're so quiet. I'm on all day. I'm just
been
work.
Talking the whole day.
Right.
Yeah.
I
feel you on that.
Mm-hmm.
But, all right, so is it hard for you to, go ahead.
No, my question was, have you ever been trying to be serious about something and then, like, people wouldn't take you serious? And you're like, no, for real, I'm not playing right now.
Yes.
And they're like, oh, ha, ha. You're like, no, like, for real.
Yeah, that happens to me all the time, but I don't know why. I think it's because I'm so animated and I talk with my hands usually and I'm just big energy or whatever. But then when I mean, like I said, listen, I'm being serious. You know what I mean? And people are like, girl, you ain't. Shut up. You lying. I'm like, no, I'm not. He did die. You know? Peter is our daddy. You know? Now, what you was going
to
ask me?
I was going to ask, is it hard for you to turn that comedian side off? Because you always, as that, and even for what we do, I always see stuff. Like, stuff happens in front of me all the time. Stuff to talk about. All the time. And sometimes you're like, hey, I don't want to see stuff for a minute that's funny or something like that.
Well, you know, I am a sponge, so I take it all in. I see humor in things that most people don't. I've been trying to be serious with the whole R. Kelly thing because it is a tragedy, right? But it's still funny. You know what I'm saying? Like, who, how, and why do you get to this point? Like, how we know? Everybody knew he was down to the people peeing on people. We knew. You know what I'm saying? But how, like, what does that look like? And where are you? And as young, and them young women, that we're going to put them aside because they don't know no better. But these old hoes, you didn't let a whole man pee on you, girl. Where is your life? I let mine pee on me sometimes. I'm just like, don't bring that bill. That's a lie. I'm just saying. But my point is, you are grown. I mean, like, some of these things you do find funny. Like, even with the Jesse Smollett. You know what I mean? Like, Jesse. Who?
Chicago.
Listen, when I tell you I was down to the airport looking for the Jesse and the R. Kelly, I tell you, listen, I want everybody. I'm looking for them. I want to go down there. I was going to put $2 on Jesse's book. I sure was. But I ain't had $2 to give him. You know what I'm saying? Like, something.
Who? R. Kelly the one need the money.
Girl, ain't nobody finna get Kelly. Kelly better be in that jail selling golden showers. Somebody won't.
How can he afford his attorney, though?
Somebody won't Kelly in jail. That's why they got him separated.
He must have had that boy on retainer from a long time ago.
I'm telling you. Cause
that's a friend.
How you gonna, you know he ain't got no money. Why you
Sean. Taking that case? But here's the thing. You know, you, to a certain extent, you take the R. Kelly, well, as an attorney, you take the R. Kelly case, because I almost went to law school. You take that case yes, and also with the hopes to win. If you win that case on R. Kelly, what? That's like getting the devil off. The devil didn't burn nobody. You know what I'm saying? The devil ain't got this big country fire. Just the devil is innocent. He offered everybody water and ice. You hear me? If he can get R. Kelly off, he will be set for the rest of his life. Now, we probably hate him. You know what I mean? But it is what it is. But I would say I do find humor in some of the worst things, and I try to be mindful of people and who are suffering or going through those things. And sometimes it's just funny. I mean, you see stuff all the time. Like, oh, that's funny. Also, yeah, that's sad.
When you really hurt somebody and they was like, no, that wasn't cool, what you said?
I'm a comedian, and so I say, look, don't hold me accountable for nothing I say. Because I'm a stand-up comedian, so some things I say might be offensive. Right. But, you know, I don't mean it from... I always try not to come from a mean spirit.
Right.
Have you ever apologized for a joke?
I don't know if I've ever apologized for a joke. No. I don't even know if I would. I don't think that... If you did not intend it to be mean...
Right.
There's no reason to apologize. And I always say this, and I say this to my sweetie all the time. And I've dropped this man. I done said sweetie 100 times because I've been cussing all day, so I'm trying to make up. Listen, I have said this. Sometimes how I say it, mm-hmm. even though I meant it away, the way it landed is two different things. You know what I'm saying? So because he might be in his feelings about something on that particular day right. or and took it a different way than I intended it, right? So even though I meant it and I thought it was funny, because I say stuff all the time that I thought, that is hilarious. But people getting their feelings about right. stuff. And I'm just like, look, that's really not
now
what I meant.
I don't want to talk to you. Right, hey, right. Answering the phone.
Right, that's not really what I meant. So I can only apologize for hurting your feelings, not apologizing for saying it because it wasn't intentionally mean.
So do you think comedians should be held to a different standard when it comes to, like, you know, social classes or, like, you know, certain types of people who feel like you shouldn't talk about us at all?
No, I think everybody's subject to that. If it's funny, it's funny. And if you offend it, okay, you offend it. Stand-up comedy has been built on offending people.
Is there
so,
such thing as too soon, though?
I think so. I think sometimes you can be a little sensitive to the fact that, it just happened now. You know what I mean? But, you know, it depends. Some comedians like Donnell Rollins. Yeah, he's hashtag, yeah, too, is it too soon? That's his thing. I personally, I try to stay away from things that are still kind of hot. Mm-hmm. Because, you know, you don't want to offend too many people.
Well, what about the people bringing stuff up from your past? Like, well, you should have said this about this group of people.
Girl, child, get over it. You know, comedians, that's what we do. We make funny of the things that are going on in our lives. And, like, you know, right now, I think, well, yes, they said that Kevin Hart said that he didn't want his son to be gay. Okay, that's his personal preference. If you don't want a gay son, you don't want a gay son. What's wrong? I don't know why the rainbow's mad about it. You know what I mean? Like, you don't,
they want a Kevin Hart son.
Like, if you, that's your son, you know what I'm saying? That's his son. He ain't got to want a gay son because y'all gay. You know what I mean?
We got Magic Johnson's son. We want
Kevin Hart's son. Your son. You know what I mean? So Kevin, like, hell no, you can't have my boy. But, I mean, I get it. You know right. what I mean? But I don't remember the joke, per se. I'm not sure how far he went. But I would say, I think sometimes people are just a little too sensitive. And I think people just need to lighten up. I think if it's, out of if it's mean spirited, we should be conscious of that. But if it's just lightly, you know, kind of haha, that's funny. It's funny.
Yeah.
But everybody's not gonna find the humor in things that you find humor in.
You got brothers and sisters?
I do. I have a 26-year-old brother, and my daddy got some kids, but I don't know them. Okay.
All right.
I know of them, and they be in my DM, girl. You know what I'm saying? I have two little brothers that I had a great relationship with at one time, and when he died, I don't know where they went. And then my oldest brother, he fell off the face of the earth. So listen, if y'all out there, call your. Do I want them to call me? Mm. Okay.
You don't want them to call you now.
Hey.
Let's go ahead. Yeah. Don't do that.
Yeah, my oldest brother, he can hit me because I miss him. He lived in Dallas.
You know him. But don't be calling him on Facebook Messenger, none of that other nonsense.
Right, talking about sis, I need some money.
Well, I had heard that the youngest child is most likely to become a comedian.
Okay, well, out of my mother's kids, I am the oldest. And my little brother and I are very different. He's quiet, kind of conservative and reserved. I'm loud, flamboyant. I am outgoing. I'm consistently, everything that I am, this is who I have been always.
Your whole life.
My whole life. I was the girl who wore glitter and sequins at 4. You know what I mean? High heels. I was Punky Brewster.
Fabulous.
I was Smurf. Fat, I was all those things, you know what I mean? So, and I went to Catholic school, so I wore a uniform all the time. And when I got the opportunity to put on the glitz and the glam, I did. Everybody had to come to my fashion show. I sold tickets. It was a mess.
No.
I was horrible.
That's what I'm talking about. But look, before we get out of here.
Where are we going? Because you ain't asked me nothing about what I do in my real life, my business. What are we doing?
They ain't, They didn't ask about that.
We don't care nothing about them.
That's it. We only got an hour.
Okay, well, let's talk about my business.
All right, so we got, let's talk about your business.
Okay.
Real quick.
All right. So not only am I a stand-up comedian, I'm an author. I have a book coming out. Y'all, please forgive me. I know many of you guys are waiting on this book. But the issue with the book is my life has changed, and I have written this book over and over and over again, and I haven't published it because it's different. I'm now in a relationship. I'm not on the show anymore. So the book is just not timely. You know what I mean? So I need to make some changes to the book. But the book is called Bye Bye Bags, Laughing to Lighten the Load. And it discusses how I use laughter to heal myself whole. We all as adults have been broken in some way. I'm a child molestation survivor. I've lost best friends, I've lost jobs, but I use my comedy to heal myself whole, and I encourage people to find something they can lean on. I use comedy in Christ to, you know, push forward through all my rough times in my life. Also, I am a franchise owner. Come on now, Al!
Just one.
No, I need multiple. So I'm a franchise owner, and it's what's interesting about this company. I am one of, there's not many black women in this business. So my mother and I and my brother, we're all co-owners of a franchise called Cell Phone Repair Store. It's called Cell Phone Repair, CPR.
Fix that.
Yep. It's in Marietta, Georgia. 50 Barrett Parkway, Marietta, Georgia.
That's by me.
Yes. So come see us. We repair everything, your cell phones, your screens, your batteries, your charging ports, droids, iPads, any kind of tablets, computers. We repair everything. The reason I got into this business is because I broke my phone last year 3 times. That was $250 a pop. And I knew if I broke my phone almost $300 3 times, that's $900. Somebody else has to.
Oh, absolutely.
So come see me. Follow us on Instagram too. It's CPR Cell Phone Repair Marietta.
Nice.
Mm-hmm. Did I tell y'all it ain't that many black folks in this business, girl? Mm-hmm. Girl, I went to the meeting. We had a regional meeting of all the owners. It was me and my mom and a whole bunch of room full of white folks, wow. White men. I'm not judging. I'm happy. Hey, but I'm here.
Yeah, they saw you though.
They did. They was like, "How you get here?" I said, "Credit and some money." Okay, shoot, I'm trying to pay it forward, leave a legacy.
Amen. That's what I'm talking about.
Hey, look, so we got to get your take on some stuff before we get out of here.
Okay, let's do it.
This is last year's Hot Topics. And real quick, So it was a lot of stuff that we argued about and debated about on this show over the last year. And so I got 5 things. Would you rather? We're going to burn through those real quick.
Okay.
And then some random questions. So would you rather? I know Buddy in here, but before Buddy.
Who was Buddy?
Your boo.
I'm not going to call him, sweetie.
Oh. I was like, who was Buddy? You talking about my man. Okay, yeah. Go ahead.
Before him, would you have rather date the dude that was cross-eyed or had a lisp?
Oh, I'll take a lisp all day long because he can keep his mouth shut, but them eyes you can't fix. You know what I'm saying? Like, he's like, hey, what are you looking at, sir?
Would you have rather date a dude with a small ding-a-ling or extreme body odor?
Can he wash? He can wash, girl. He can wash. He can wash.
No, not in this question, he can't.
He can't wash.
There ain't no soap for that.
Well, I pass on both. I don't need neither one of them. You can't
you
be stinking.
Pick one.
Why?
That's part of what you rather.
All right, small, because I can go to the store and fix myself. You know what I mean? I get a rabbit, a kangaroo. You don't necessarily need no man. You want them, but you don't need them.
All right, so would you rather date a dude with 2 lazy eyes or 3 prosthetic limbs?
3? That means 2. No arms and no leg?
What?
Do he got a job?
You can choose which
2 lazy
which
eyes.
Which limb exists. Which limb is real.
I'll go ahead and date Music Soul Child. Go ahead.
All right, and so the last one on this one. For $1 million, would you take... Would you rather have 5 elephant boo-boo pies to the face or for $10 million, 100 people spit on you?
Who are you?
Where does it come
from? Where did this come from? This is disgusting.
Okay,
so here's the thing. I struggle with answering that question. Like, I really don't even like to kiss people who don't floss. You know what I mean? So this is an issue with me. You know what I mean? Like, I can't.
Mouth juice don't work.
It won't work for me, so I got to go with the elephant. This is horrible.
Everybody said the elephant.
Nobody spit. We don't know if they DNA. We don't
Everybody
know if they tested.
The
we need the people to, you know, swab your throat. What's your mouth?
The elephant only eating, like, you know,
trees.
Grass.
Them turds are major, though.
No, dude. Are you crazy? I can't do that. Like, I'm very funny acting about, like, hygiene. Like, I can't. So that would be an issue for me. I probably have a heart attack.
All right. And so, random questions. If your man gets beat up defending your honor, did he succeed?
Yes. If he did succeed, if he'll at least try. Let somebody try me and he'll run up. Because then I'm like, there you go, cookie forever. You know what I'm saying? Now you single. But, I mean, at least he tried.
Okay.
Ooh, I'm hungry. Seems like I'm hungry. Hey, Reggie. Hey, Reggie Rouse. This your girl, Kiara Dancy, and I'm on the radio since you wouldn't come check me out. Hey.
What's up, Reg? Anyway.
Okay. So the people invited me down here to the radio show to say hello. Go ahead.
If a man proposes to a woman and she says no, is the relationship over?
I would think he would not want to be with her anymore because how do you, first of all, there's a reason she's saying no, but she has not communicated that with him. But I would not want to be with a woman who I proposed to her and then she say no. Like, what is the reason?
We're done.
There could be multiple reasons, but I mean, you got to help him get his face off the floor.
Break up, fam.
So you think the relationship is over if a woman if you propose to a woman and she says no?
Break up, fam. We ain't on the same page. Break up, fam.
Y'all might not even be in the same book. How about that?
Absolutely.
If you thought you could propose to a woman and she said, and you didn't know that she was going to say no.
That's why you
break up. You ain't test the water.
That's why you break up.
Right.
That's why dudes be waiting for the ultimatum.
You want some cookie? Gotta put a ring on it.
That's why dudes wait for the ultimatum.
Right.
All
right.
So, if you in the moment and an R. Kelly song comes on while he getting it in, do you make him get up and change songs?
Yes. You're not going to be making love to me to a child pedophile. Like, no. And don't get me wrong. It's been some good loving made on R. Kelly. But, you know, something about me can't stop. I can't get that out of my mind.
Alexa, please
I can't
step
get
the next
song. R. Kelly urinating on that little girl out of my mind. And then I saw the video when he was talking to the 14-year-old girl. Like, I can't get that out of my mind. I don't want to be with my man and I'm thinking about R. Kelly with a 14-year-old girl. That is not okay. Seems like you're ready.
Do you send food back?
All the time. If it's not ready, if it's not right, if it's not hot, if it looks crazy, I send it back.
I can't send food back.
Listen, this is what I do, though. I speak directly to the manager. And I always say, hey, I patronize this business all the time. I love your business. But today it's not a great day for you guys. So I would love if you can, you know, and go to the manager. And then always say, I know your managing partner, whatever. You got to say you know somebody. You can't just be like, they cook, no. So you make sure you tell them that your food is not right. And then explain to them, you know, how you would, I'll give you a raving review if you bring my hot food back.
I'm on Yelp right now.
Right.
Okay.
Right. But I'm real petty. I'm very petty with mine.
Like, I don't like how this, your food presentation is trash?
No, but it has to be hot. I want my food so hot. Like, when they say the plate is hot, I'm cool with it. Let me burn my hands. I got mama hands. I don't have any kids, but I can touch hot stuff.
Right.
Let me blow it.
You want it sizzling.
Don't bring it out here talking about, I got it cool for you. No, sir. I want to blow it myself.
Oh, gotcha.
Right.
Gotcha. All right. And is it disgusting to pick something out of your teeth and eat it?
It's your food. What would you do? What would you do with it?
Some people pick it out and then they're like,
I would say if it's a big old chunk of old meat, yeah, you should probably.
Old meat?
Old meat, girl.
Like breakfast meat?
I mean, bacon, sausage, whatever's in your mouth, you probably should pick it out and spit it out. But, I mean, we've all done it. Floss your teeth and then swallow. But, I mean, it's in your mouth.
You've already ate it once. So, I mean, I don't know why it's.
That's what I don't.
To recycle but I'm, it.
You pick it out. There's two ways to do it. There's to pick it out and then kind of put it in your mouth. And then there's to pick it out, look at it, and then try to eat it. Like, you ain't having a whole nother meal.
But why would you look at it?
People do that.
That's nasty.
You ain't stick your hand in your mouth. That's
absolutely
already
not.
Nasty.
I think
if you got a little toothpick.
Well, even if you got it on the end of the toothpick.
What is this?
Yes, I think that you should pick it. I think you should floss often. And I think that if something comes up off that floss, don't go to licking the floss. Okay? This. Flick it. Like, yo, go. Right.
That's hilarious. That is hilarious.
What you got?
All right, so the last one. You were married for 3 years and dated for 6 before then. And one of your...
So y'all together 9 years.
9 years.
Mm-hmm.
Your mate's ex passed away. Can that person go to the funeral?
Yes. Why not? Let me tell you something.
Men and women always feel
like I don't care. Like I care less. Let me explain something to you. My thing is that person. No, that person. No. that person meant something to you at one time in your life. You cannot deny that. At the end of the day, if you're confident in your relationship, you shouldn't be concerned about who that person. If you dated that person, well, how long was the boy were they together?
Been 3 years.
They were together together for 3 years.
It was together 3 years. There was some other.
So they've known each other for a long time.
Some other dating
and
in between that.
And you don't know
that.
The dynamics of the family. The families may know each other. I think a person should be confident enough. Look, you're speaking to the wrong person about that, because I'm also an advocate of my man having female friends. I don't want to be his only female friend. I think it's healthy for him to have female friends so that he can.
You gotta know his lock code.
No, I don't, but I don't understand why you have one. What are you hiding? You know what I mean? I also think that it's okay. Your female friends should be my friends. If you have female friends that can call you, she should be able to come around, hang out. Where her man at? Like, she can't rely on my man. My man can't be her only homeboy. How about that?
But what if it's an ex who wants to be friends?
No, exes can't be friends. Find something to be. Find somewhere to be and find
somewhere
to
die.
But they can die.
They can die.
Can his ex come to y'all wedding?
Yes. Ugh. I want her to see all this luxury, all this old dumb exuberance. Come on, girl.
They ain't got no business.
Girl, come
she gonna stand up and be like,
hey,
anybody?
Nah, she not gonna do that. No, she's not. We'll have her a seat, and we gonna have her ass sitting in the corner. We gonna give her the best of the best. Absolutely.
If
come
anybody
let me,
sees,
come.
Fit,
but I'm petty like that.
That this
I don't really care.
Union
you know
should
what I'm saying?
Not
a lot
take
of things,
place. Please stand up and state your...
No, Jay, you don't get it. A lot of things that people are bothered by, I'm just not, because I'm very confident, and I feel like if you are taking care of home, nothing else should matter. Like, when I tell you I take care of home, I cook, clean, down, you hear me? So, if you out in these streets...
Not the regular.
Like, not, down.
No, see.
Down. So, if you're not doing... If you're not happy, I mean, either you didn't tell me what you wanted.
Hey,
like, if you say you wanted...
boots.
This...
Not iPhone 7.
He Disneyland.
I'm over Disneyland too. Girl, I've been to Disneyland so many times. Mom don't even want to do that no more. But I think if you take care of home, there's no reason for people to stray. But people do. They stray. They're for whatever
like
reason.
To do with you.
It does not. There's an unfulfillment within them. So that takes communication.
Absolutely. And on that note,
come on now.
You got anything you want to play? That's our hour.
You want what I want to play? Music wise?
Plug.
Oh, I just want the people to know they can follow me on Instagram, Facebook, Twitter, all things social. I'm the same. KIANA. DANCIE, Kiana Dancy. And Kiana Dancy is also my website. I have a book coming out. Please come see me at my cell phone repair store, CPR Cell Phone Marietta. It's 50 Barrett Parkway, Marietta, Georgia. And we're open Monday through Saturday, 10:30 to 6:30, and Sunday, 12 to 4.
If they want to see you do comedy.
I'll be at the Atlanta Comedy Theater. I'm there basically every weekend. I will be there this weekend, Friday and Saturday, I think. But, you know, check my website, check my Instagram. I definitely will let you know. Send me a message, and if I'm there, if you are, and if I'm in a good mood, maybe I'll give you tickets.
Any specials coming out?
There has been talks. I am talking to a couple. You're trying to get me to drop off my jewels. I have some things happening. I'm reality show, sitcom. There's a lot of things happening. But right now, the focus has been my franchise. I got one location in Marietta, and I have a secondary location coming in Duluth. So I got to make sure this business is successful, because if I never book another show, I'm going to eat still.
Where can they catch you on TV?
I'm not on Sister Circle Live anymore, but it's coming. I got something happening.
Gotcha.
Mm-hmm.
All right. Anything you want?
She about to have her baby in 3 days.
Yes.
Yeah.
She's going to have her baby in 2 hours.
She about to have her baby right here on air.
Go ahead and go into the
right
neighborhood.
Right here on air.
Hey,
go ahead.
Bieber.
We got
hey,
a doula. She going to play a doula.
I ain't nobody's doula.
Right
I'm
now.
Run.
Go ahead.
I'm be like, ah, blood, let's go. You know, but I do know what to do. I'll tell you to push from way over there.
You're making me laugh through the contractions.
Right.
Right. Go ahead and pop that baby right on out.
Are we done?
Yeah, good people. Make sure you tune in next week. We will be back. I thank everybody for tuning in right now. Y'all have been dope. Thank you for sticking with us for these last 2 years and coming through and celebrating with us.
Oh, this is your anniversary.
Absolutely.
Happy anniversary.
That's what I'm talking about. I do thank you for coming out, too.
Yeah. Well, thank you for having me. I do understand that you could have had so many other people, but I appreciate you choosing me. And it's always fun hanging out with people who are doing big things. Congratulations on your baby. And tell your wife, hey, boo.
Oh, well, she watching. Hey. I think if she ain't sleep already. But y'all take it easy. Be safe out in these streets. Snow
Bye.
Patrol. Shout out to Sean John, too.